In this video, we'll show you how to use variables and no-code formulas to make the data displayed on the page more dynamic. We'll do this in two different ways. First, we'll spend some time calculating how many minutes we spent in calls, and then we will update our progress bar so that it dynamically changes based on how long we spent, how much of our plan we already spent. Okay, we want to calculate how much time we spent in calls. What we have is we have external data from a REST API with a list of calls. So we have from index 0 to index 999. So that's 1,000 calls that we have. And in each call, we have the duration, how long it lasted in seconds. So what we want to do is we want to calculate how many minutes we spent in calls. In order to do this, we'll select the text element here, which is in our HTML navigator, and we'll look at our data. So we can see the data, the external data that we added to WeWeb. We can see it in this tab here. And here we have our list of calls. The list is actually, this is the entire collection. So we have the list of calls. We have information on whether it's currently being fetched or has been fetched already. In this case, it has already been fetched. It has information on the pagination that we added on our collection here and how many items are in the collection. So we know we have 1,000 items. Now, we have a list of calls. The thing is, we're not interested in all of the information here. We're only interested in the duration. So in order to get all the duration, what we can do is we can use a no-code formula called rollup. Let's have a look at it here. Let me remove this and let's unbind this first. So in my no-code formulas here, I will go ahead and look at the rollup formula. And what the rollup formula does is that it takes an array. So for example, our list of calls. And if you tell it which key in the array, which column name you want from the array, it will list the values from that column. So let's select rollup. First item it wants to know is the array. So the array, we said it was our list of calls and not the object, not the entire object, but the list, so the array. And we said that in the object, we were only interested in duration. So that's the key of, that's the column name in our table, which is also called a key when referring to an object. So let's go ahead and type in duration. And now we have all of this. We only have the value for duration for each of the objects in our array. So we see here, for example, duration, if on index 0, duration is 6717, which we can see here. If we say index 1, we have duration 1122, which is here. So we're pretty happy because now we have a new array, a new list with the values that we're interested in. Now, this is still pretty unhelpful on the page. It doesn't look like what we would want to display. So let's have a look again at our no-code formulas and find out if we could do some math, if we can sum this information. So we have a sum formula here, which is similar, you know, to formulas you would have in Excel or Google Sheets or Airtable. And we have this sum formula here, which expects an array. And let's see what happens if, since this is an array, the current value is an array, let's see what happens if we wrap it inside a sum formula. Pretty cool. It looks like this summed all the seconds from our calls. The thing is, we actually want it in minutes. So let's divide all of this by 60. Now we have a list of the sum of how many minutes we spent on calls. Okay, it's getting better, but again, we have the 0.9. So we can, again, use this round formula and wrap what we have here, the current value, inside the round formula. And the round formula is basically takes a value and rounds it up. So now we have this nice looking number. We might also want to add a little bit of information saying minutes, for example, but we don't want it to be all against the 8. So we'll just add a space here. And you see that the current value you see here is what is displayed on the page. So sometimes it helps to look here. Okay, now this this formula is all no code, but if you wanted to, just know that you could move into JS and JavaScript and actually play around. You see here that you have this refers to the formula name, but this here refers to your collection. It's a unique ID that you can work with. So if you ever need to, know that it's possible to switch to JavaScript for more advanced use cases. You will never get stuck with no code. Let's go back to our formula and we'll paste back what we had. This is pretty cool already, but let's go one step further and work with variables. So here we have a progress bar. You see the progress bar here in the HTML tree. What if we could change this to match this information? So here we actually spent 59,000 minutes out of 5,000 minutes. So we went way over our plan, but let's display this. Let's show on the progress bar that we went overboard. What we can do first is we'll create a variable here in the data set. We can go ahead and create a variable and we'll call it max minutes. It will be a number. So you have different types of variables that we can create. In this case, we'll choose a number and the default value will be 5,000. Like we have here, the 5,000 minutes. Now you can see all your variables here. So these are the variables from the project. These are the two variables that are linked to the navigation menu. And this is the variable that we just created. And these are component variables. So this is, for example, the variable from related to the progress bar element, which we'll be using in a second. Back in the navigator and back here, instead of having always slash 5,000 minutes, we want to make this dynamic because maybe our data plan is more or less, maybe we have a higher maximum number of minutes. Here, what we want to do with the little plug again that invites us to make this data dynamic. We'll go ahead and say, I will look for a variable here in the variable tab, the max minutes variable that we just created. And we can bind it here. Now, what we had first is we had slash 5,000 in min. So let's do that. Let's go back to our no code formulas. And what we can do is we'll use the concatenate formula. In this case, it tells us that we need to have the text and then comma and then the next text and all that. So let's remove this max minute and put it here instead. Max minutes. And actually before max minutes, I want a slash. So let me add that. And I want a space after the slash. So I need to do that. And after the variable, I want this. So slash 5,000 minutes. And now if my max minute changes, this will be updated. So I could change it here, for example, if I change it to 4,000, it dynamically changes here, which we can also see in the current value here and here. Switch it back to 5,000. Now, what we want to do is we want to bind the progress on this progress bar. we want to bind it to this rollup formula that we had. Here what we'll do is we'll take our formula here that we use to calculate how many minutes we spent in calls, and we will go ahead and turn it into a reusable formula. So I only need the number, I don't need the concatenation, but I want to reuse this, and this is the minutes spent. Let's save this. Now that I have this formula that tells me how many minutes I spent, I can go ahead and use it to bind the value of my progress bar. So I will go and find my custom formula of minutes spent. And what I want to display in my progress bar is the minutes spent divided by the max minutes, so the maximum minutes I have on my plan. And then I want a percentage, so I want to multiply it by 100. And I'm good to go. So my progress bar, of course, you know, it doesn't overflow, but it's full. I spent all of my plan. And now I would like to update this information as well. So let's do that. Again, I will look for my formula to calculate all the minutes I spent. And you see now the power of using a reusable formula. I will again say divided by max minutes times 100 to have the percentage. And I will add the concatenation, display it as the percentage on here. So that's an absurd percentage. I spent way more minutes and calls than I should have. Okay, and finally, maybe we want to show this as red because we filled up, we already spent all that we could spend. So on the progress bar in this tile, we can reuse, again, this formula of minutes spent. And we can divide it by our max minutes. Again, 100. So maybe even this formula I could add here. I could add this formula as well. Minutes spent. See, I can use reusable formulas inside reusable formulas. And this is percent spent. So now instead of having this complex formula here, I could just refer to my new formula, percent spent. And I could say, I could use a conditional formula to say, if the result of this is over 100, I want the color to be red. Otherwise, I want it to be blue. And there we go. And so here, if I made my plan 500,000, suddenly the percentage, I only spent 11% or 12%, and the bar is blue again. That's it. As you can imagine, these notions of bindings, variables, and formulas are extremely powerful. We're barely scratching the surface here. We'll keep exploring more and more complex use cases throughout these videos, but just know that if you want to, you can also learn more about these in the user documentation at docs.weweb.io.